Namaste children, I am Smita, your English teacher from Mangala Vidya Mandira. Class 8 standard, subject English. In today's class, let us learn the grammar related to the lesson called as Sir C.V. Raman, prose to Sir C.V. Raman. So let us learn the grammar related to that particular lesson. So let us begin with the opposite words. Fill in the blanks with the words opposite in meaning to the words underlined. We should neither borrow nor. What is the opposite of borrow, children? Opposite of borrow is lend. The answer is lend. Why do you feel old? Feel? Answer is young. The opposite of old is young. Third, don't stand outside. Come inside. The opposite of outside is inside. Next, are wealthy people really happy or? What is the opposite of happy? Sad, isn't it? Next, eat less but work. The opposite of less is more. Now coming to the next part, what is called as homophones. Now what are homophones? Homophones are words that have a different spelling, different meaning, but the same pronunciation. See, for example, I went to the sea to see the ship. So in this example, the words see, S-E-A-C, and S-E-E, see, have the same pronunciation, but different meanings and spellings. They are called as homophones. Okay, let us see a few examples of homophones. Now the pronunciation of the following pairs of words are almost the same, but the different meaning. Use each word in the pair to form meaningful sentences. Now coming to the first part, break, B-R-E-A-K, break, and B-R-A-K-E, break. So, B-R-E-A-K, break means crack, or it can also mean a short gap. B-R-A-K-E, the second break, is to make a moving vehicle slow down or stop by using a break, isn't it? See the sentence, first one, I took a short break from my work. The second break, I applied brake to my vehicle. Similarly, new and new, one is K-N-E-W and the other one is N-E-W. The first new means aware of something. The second one means a recent one, isn't it? New. Let us see the examples. The first one, I knew the answer to the question that my teacher asked. Look at the next new. I purchased a new dress yesterday. Coming to the next part, look at this sight, S-I-G-H-T, sight, and S-I-T-E, sight. The first sight, that means power of seeing, isn't it? S-I-G-H-T means the power of seeing. The second sight, S-I-T-E, it's an area of ground. So look at the example. First one, the old man lost his eyesight. Next, sight, S-I-T-E, that is the government is looking for a site to build a new school. Similarly, you have some, S-O-M-E, some, and S-U-M, some. The first sum means a certain amount or number that is not specified. Second sum, S-U-M, that means total from adding numbers, isn't it? Look at the example, first one, I had some rice for lunch today. Next sum, the sum of 4 and 2 is 6. I hope you have understood this, children. Coming to the next, place and place. The first one, place means engaging in activity for enjoyment, place. Next one, P-L-A-C-E, it's a particular point or position, isn't it, or an area, etc. So first place, example, the child plays in the park. The second place, Mysore is a nice place to visit. Now coming to the next part, what is called as the phrasal verbs. Now what is a phrase? A phrase is a group of words that is a part of a sentence, isn't it? For example, very tall, was reading, on the table, etc. So phrase is nothing but group of words that is a part of a sentence. Now what is phrasal verbs? It is a phrase that consists of a verb with preposition or adverb or both. Look at the example. went on, broke into, look around, etc. So what is the meaning of went on? Went on means proceed, isn't it? Broke into means open. Similarly, look around means search. So the phrasal verb might have two meanings in some cases, like turn down. Turn down means reduced volume, or turn down can also mean rejected. Okay. Now coming to the next part, what is called as idioms. Now idioms are group of words whose meaning is different from that of the usual meanings of its separate or individual words. So what are idioms? Idioms are group of words whose meaning is different from that of the usual meaning of their separate or individual words. So directly what is seen in the words is different from its actual meaning. For example, fish out of water. Fish out of water means in a bad situation. Or the early bird catches the worm. What is the meaning of the early bird catches the worm? It doesn't mean that the bird will come early and catch the worm, but it means that if you do something in a timely manner, then you will definitely succeed. Okay, so these are the idioms. So coming to the exercise part now. Fill in the blanks with suitable phrasal verbs or idioms, choosing from the ones given in brackets. Okay, idioms as well as phrasal verbs are given in the brackets. For example, make up, put up with, give up, put on, a fish out of water, make out, break down, etc. Now let us go to the examples, children. Look at the example. We usually dash cotton cloths during summer. We usually put on cotton cloths during summer. Next. One day a villager came to me and asked me to read a letter. I tried my best but could not dash what the person had written. Okay, so what is the answer? Make out. Okay, so but could not make out what the person had written. So here make out means manage with some difficulty to hear or see something. Okay, or understand something. Next. People should dash their mind to fight against corruption. People should, what is the answer? Make up their mind to fight against corruption. Okay, make up is the answer. That means compensate for something. Okay, next. Great people or persons have an ocean of patience. They have learned to dash difficulties. So what is the answer, children? Put up with difficulties. So what is the meaning of put up with? Put up with difficulties means tolerate something. Okay. So Raju's health used to break down now and then. So he had to give up the highly paid post of accountant in an office. At first he felt like fish out of water. So what is the meaning of breakdown? Breakdown is sudden collapse or reduction. So what is the meaning of give up? Give up is stopping from doing something before it is completed. Next one is fish out of the water. I told you about this, which means in a bad situation. Okay, now coming to the next part. Let us move on to the compound words. So what are compound words? Compound words are formed when two or more words are put together to form a new word with a new meaning. Look at the examples given. Air plus plane is airplane. Day plus dream is daydream. Butter plus milk is buttermilk. Honey plus comb is honeycomb. So compound words are formed when two or more words are put together to form a new word with a new meaning. So make compound words with the words given in columns A and B. So it's like match the following. Boy, boy, hood, G. G is the answer, boyhood. Time, what is the answer? Table, time, table. First class. Next, road, map, isn't it? Road map. Speed, post. Class, mate, class, mate. So, class plus mate is classmate. This is how you join the words and make the compound words. Okay, children, let us come to the next part, what is called as prefixes. You have already learnt about prefixes, isn't it? So what is a prefix? Prefix refers to a letter or letters added before or at the beginning of the word. So adding it to the beginning of the word changes it into another word. For example, when the prefix un, un is added to the word happy, it creates the word unhappy, isn't it? Now let us go through the exercise. Give the negative forms of the underlined words using a prefix like in, un, dis, im. Okay. So example, a popular poem. So what is the negative form of popular? It is unpopular, isn't it? A popular poem, an unpopular poem. An interesting story. So what is the negative form? An uninteresting story. So un, un is the prefix added to interesting. So it has become uninteresting. Similarly, you have a fortunate thing. The opposite of it is an unfortunate thing. Opposite of fortunate is unfortunate. Correct, incorrect. A correct answer, an incorrect answer. A pure heart, an impure heart. A happy day, an unhappy day. An honest person, a dishonest person. So, children, giving the negative forms also means that you are writing the opposites, isn't it? Opposite of interesting is uninteresting. Opposite of correct is incorrect. Opposite of happy is unhappy. So, these are all the opposite words also. Now, let us come to the next part, what is called as the simple present tense. Children, you all know what tense is, isn't it? Tense means time. Present tense is used for actions which are happening now, isn't it? Present tense represents actions which are happening now. So what is simple present tense? Simple present tense is used to express habits, general truths, repeated actions or unchanging situations, emotions and wishes. So examples for habits and repeated actions. My mother walks early in the morning. She always eats healthy food. So these are the actions that happens every day or the actions which are repeated every now and then. General truths like the earth revolves round the sun. The oceans are deep and cold. So simple present tense expresses habits, general truths and repeated actions. Now coming to the next part, what is called as the present continuous tense. So, present continuous tense describes the events that are occurring now at the present moment. At this particular time, the action is happening. So, the present continuous tense is used to talk about actions that are happening at this current moment. Present continuous is also called present progressive because it is in progress at this moment. Look at the structure of the present continuous tense, children. You have the subject plus be forms. Which are the be forms? Am, is, are. They are called as be forms. Plus verb. Plus ing. Plus rest of the sentence. Look at the example there. A boy is running in the field. Okay, look at the subject boy. And be form is. Run is a verb. Plus you have the ing form. So running. Plus rest of the sentence. That is in the field. Okay. So, you have to remember the structure. If you remember the structure, it is easy to write about the present continuous tense or any other tenses. Similarly, the next example, a student is reading a book. Student, subject plus be form is. Read, read is the verb, ing plus ing form and then the rest of the sentence, a book. So, a student is reading a book. Similarly, you have the other examples. A girl is eating a fruit. My mother is lighting the lamp. So, these are the actions that is happening now at this moment. Okay. That's why it is called as present continuous tense. I hope you have understood today's grammar, children. Let us go to the homework part. Now you have task 2, match the words in column A with the words in column B that is given in page 29 in your textbook. Similarly, you have the second homework, task 2, rearrange the words to form meaningful sentences that is page 30 in your textbook. So complete this in your homework book and send it through WhatsApp. Thank you, children.